My husband will say, Mom, you gotta go walk it. Walk. No? Your palda is stretched. And I said, Lord, ang sakit naman. Forgive him, Lord. He doesn't know what he's saying. Talking about palda, there was one story of my life, the most embarrassing moment of my life. I went to a house dedication. I prayed for the apartment. We had fellowship. We did all the things that we're praying for the place. We had our dinner or lunch, late lunch. We have everything. And then we prayed for the first timers. I prayed for the first timers and I'm about to go home. And we say goodbye, hugs one another, kisses, hugs, hugs. And then at the door, I was standing by the door and trying to put my shoes on. Good thing the place, the entrance, I mean the exit door was a bit dark. I was putting my one leg to the shoes. And then I looked down and I said, oh, my skirt is down. Ang palda ko ho, nahulog. Sabi ko, Lord, hindi naman itong tinatawag na self-emptying or taking out everything. Kahiya-hiya naman. So we were laughing each other. We were like, imagine, there was a powerful thing that the Lord has allowed us to experience. And then coming home, God is always with a sense of humor. Putting my legs on and I said, why my skirt on my legs? Nalaglag yung palda ko. Ito ibig sabihin, dininig ng Diyos ang panalangin ko. Hindi ako malusog, no? Hindi ako mataba. Pumayat ako, nalaglag ang palda ko eh. Sometimes in our Christian life, it is good that we always, whatever happens to us, that God allows things to happen in a perspective that with a, knowing with a divine purpose. Why it happened to me that day? I lack wisdom. I usually, because I ate too much on that lunch. I ate too much and my palda just plack. And a good thing is I was wearing already my jacket, which is baloney level. So covered yung kahihiyan ko. And I said to my husband again inside the cab saying to me, wow, Mom. Wow. Oh, that's all you can say? Wow? But my brothers and sisters, it's very true. Humiliation comes, but when we take it that it is part of our enjoyment to serve God. I serve God. I said, Lord, I prayed to these people. I even officially dedicate their place. Why embarrass me? No, I did not embarrass you. Remember, I ask you first in the wisdom to put on your jacket because your skirt is going down. Oh! The most embarrassing moment of my life. But come to think of it, Jesus, he experienced more than that. Amen? So when I put myself onto this one, oh nga naman Panginoon, ikaw nga eh. Naipako pa sa krus. You know, he made himself nothing. All these divine privileges. For us, even followers of Christ, it's hard for us to obey. It's hard for us to follow. Because in giving up our rights and privileges, sometimes it causes our pride to be there, you know. It's hard for us to swallow the pride that we have. That's why it's hard for us to even release forgiveness, to release love. It's hard for us to even share what we have. You know, it's hard for us. Because you will say, how can I be give in? How can I put down myself to his level? I am in a theology. Whatever kind of theology you may finish, whatever kind of master degree you have finished, master lahat na ng master. You know what? When it comes to the Lord, that's nothing. When there is no God in you, that's all absolutely nothing. Amen? So I said to myself, Lord God, o nga naman, o ba naman ang kahihiyang ko dun? Buti nga, may palda ka pa eh, na nalaglag. E paano kung iba ang nalaglag? And the thing is, my brothers and sisters, that's how it is. The only way for us to be in greatness is for us to be in the lowest position. Amen? In the lowest position. Jesus descended. Jesus descended to the lowest of the lowest position of a man. To the lowest position of the man. But he comes because God was pleased upon him. God blessed him. But of course, and there is a time in his life, even at the dying at the cross, he was saying, he was screaming, he was crying out to the Lord. He is pouring out his heart to the Lord. My God, why have you forsaken me? He cried. Why have you abandoned me? He cried. Was God abandoning Jesus Christ in a physical realm? Because God is God, he cannot look upon sin. Hindi siya makatingin sa kasalanan. Ayaw niya. So when Jesus took that price, took away our sins, he bore our sins in himself. He took it, you know? He become a sinless man, become sin, stained. He become naging makasalanan. Siya ang naging kasalanan. To put it in the proper word. He became the sin. So God, at that time, let it be. But after that, the glory has been revealed. Right? He did not remain dead. He rose from the dead on the third day. And now sits at the right hand of God. My brothers and sisters, Jesus as the ultimate example of selflessness. Ultimate, extreme. No one can ever do that. No one could ever die on that cross. That on the third day, he arose again. I remember when I was in Pampanga, the place of my husband, there was a Holy Week time. There were so many people trying to entaw dun. They paku themselves on the cross. And then after that, they go to a little bit water river just to wash the thing. And then after that, nagiinuman na. And then I said, what is this? Temporarily absolution of the sin, they call it. But for us, we were given already the absolute atonement of our sin, the life of our Lord Jesus Christ, the shedding of his blood. In his obedience and love to God the Father, he is obedient even to the point of death, to the death on the cross. My brothers and sisters, it's a good thing that we can understand fully what this God we are talking about. Every Sunday, every time we meet together with our fellow brothers, every time we talk about the Word of God, every time we talk about how God has given us hope, life, you know, how God has given us his provision, his forgiveness, in all these things, even trials and persecutions, yes, we are not excused to experience this on earth because we are still here on earth. But one thing for sure, our God is always with us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. He will always be there no matter what. I'm telling you, there's so many experiences we can encounter in our lives. I myself have so much, I call it sufferings and trials in my life. But one thing for sure, I always go look back to the Lord. Lord God, I am not worthy of your calling, but because of your great love, I can stand. So my brothers and sisters, Jesus have done the best. Our Lord have done the best thing. The good Samaritan, he thinks for what is best, but it's limited. But the Lord Jesus Christ, what he has done on that cross is the absolute act of will. In his conscience and his mind, in his obedience to the will of God, the Father. Amen? Amen. So he humbled himself at another point because our God, our Lord God, is a humble person. Matthew chapter 11, verse 29, in the letter B, it says here, I am gentle and lowly and humble in heart. Jesus Christ, a humble person. Jesus Christ bent down, descended to the lowest part of his life, of his being a man on earth. He became the sin because of our sin. And God is pleased and he restored the glory for for his, to the glory of himself. And God knows what he was doing, and that is his great commission for everyone to be redeemed from the eternal damnation, from the pit of hell. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, it says, God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. From Jesus Christ dying on that cross, now ascended to heaven, the glory has been revealed. And for the righteousness of God to come upon us, there is someone should be to die for us because of our sin. And that the Lord Jesus Christ has done. He did the ultimate example of being selflessness, of being selfless, of being open to everything that he could give to someone that is for us. In obedience, he humbled himself even to the point of death, even to the cross of death on the cross, even to the death on the cross. My brothers and sisters, before I close, in our life as a Christian, I know each one of us here have some kinds of dealings in our life, experiencing difficulties, experiencing trials, problems, persecutions, worries. We believe that somehow we almost go to the brim of giving up. Sometimes I myself experience that sometimes I want to just leave everything, just give up. Sometimes I just want to say, I could be very rich right now. I can talk. I can speak English. Kahit Baluktot o Ilocano, no. But the point here is, my plan was changed by God for a different kind of dimension, because his plan is higher than my plan. His ways is higher than my ways. I believe that in my entire life of serving God, from the time that I was in the Philippines when I was growing up, I was very active already in, you know, as the kabataang barangay in our Mandaluyong area, you know. I involved in every activities of the young people. And then I involved in every activities of our church at that time, but not knowing my personal Lord and Savior, but not knowing that he has done the ultimate, that very greatest part, act of redeeming me from my sin, not knowing. I know there is God at that time, his existence, but I don't have a personal relationship with him. And then when I come to Singapore to work because of hardship of living, my brother was sick, my father was sick, and they're now both gone to the Lord. My father, at that time when I was in Singapore working, I didn't even know from his sickness that he was already a born-again Christian. He was watching the television, the Jesus the Healer. He was first got saved before me. And then when I went to Canada, I joined the fellowship of the sisters starting here in Canada, year 1991. And in my life, I said, pag naging born again ako, maybe I will not experience any more trials and problems. Maybe I will not experience hard life. I'm not excused on that. I still experience those things, but the difference that I can see, whenever I experience those things, there is God. He's helping me along the way. With all the struggles, with all even getting married, and then having a baby, all these things, that I almost lost my son because of that infliction, infirmity of having cyst in my right ovary, being put in the laundry area to sleep with my husband because of selfishness of a person, we found out there is always God. We did not give up on our life, just seeking God. Sabi ko, Lord, if I am not with you, I mean, if there is no God, whoever is watching right now on television, there is God. If there is no God, I said to myself, Lord, kung wala ka, if you're not with me, where will I be? Where will I be? If not with this ministry, where will I go? And I thank God for 25 years. I fell, I rise up. I fell, I rise up. That's all you have to do, amen? you fall down, you go up. Because even Jesus Christ, when he was suffering, how many times he fell down carrying the cross, the heaviness of the cross, he still stood up. So my brothers and sisters, our God has given us the Lord Jesus Christ as the ultimate example for selflessness. Before I close, allow me to share this one. There is a man that I truly admired, a very young man. I'm saying this to you not to be conceited of myself, not to be pleasing anybody. I'm just saying to you the truth. This young man I admired, I'd say he's good Samaritan because he's not selfish or conceited, but with humility in his mind regarding others is more important than himself. You know, it's more important than himself. Not for his own personal interest, but for the interest of others. Again, others. He knows in his obedience, this young man, he knows in his obedience to do what is right, not only for his family, not only for his friends, but even for his country. He knows that in his obedience, he will please God. And we know that when God is pleased, he releases blessing. Amen? And I said to myself, Lord God, in humility, this young man, he has given his attention. He looked upon what is the best for the young people, for the next generation, for the next future. He looked upon, his attention was there. He spent his time telling the people, this is what we must have to do. We have to move on. We have to really move on. And then he even transported his own pocket to even share. And again, that is for the interest, not for himself. Not only for his family, but it's for his country. Let us all arise. Sometimes when we look upon the word selflessness, when we look upon the word, opposite the word selfish, it hits our heart. Because in that inner man of ours, there is that being selfish. But God is telling us, whenever you help somebody in need, whenever you think of someone about his own benefits, his interest, than your interest, whenever you stretch forth your help to someone, God is paying you back. He will pay you back. Philippians chapter 2, verse 3 to 4, it says here, do nothing from selfish or empty conceit, but with humility of mind. With humility of mind. Regard one another as more important than yourselves. Do not merely look out for your own personal interest, but also for the interest of others. In my life, sometimes they say I lack wisdom. I share our house, even when it was small. I let people stay in. People will go, people will stay, people will leave us. Sometimes people are not happy. They will talk bad about you. They will talk so much things about you. But I said to my God, Lord God, why is it that I'm experiencing this? When they are in need, I let them in. And then when they go out, they destroy you. And then I started a word and it says, don't worry about what they've done to you. Be comforted for what I'm going to do to you. The Lord knows everything. He is our God. He is our Lord. My brothers and sisters, difficult times come upon our hearts. Difficult times come upon our lives. But have you ever thought of losing someone? Even in the thinking of losing someone in your life. Friday night when I shared a prayer meeting about the enduring faith, that accounting it all joy, knowing the divine purpose of God, Coming home around 10:30, I found out that my son was not home. I started to worry and start calling him, sending messages to him, "Christian, where are you?" No response. 11 o'clock, "Christian, where are you? I'm worried." 12 o'clock, midnight, "If you're not answering your mom, you're not answering my text, I'm going out there, Christian, to look for you." 1 o'clock, because I know my son, for 19 years that my son with me, he never will miss to tell, "Mom, I'm here, don't worry, Mom, I'm with the CYN," he will never miss that. 1 o'clock, I start my heartbeat. Where is my son? 2 o'clock, I said, "If you're not going to respond to this text, Christian, I will report you to the police. You're lost." I know it's not the proper way. 2:30, I called brethren, the mothers that has young people, and their children, their young people already asleep. 2:30, after that, I called my husband. I told my husband, "Christian is not home." 3 o'clock, I start crying to the Lord. "Lord God, where is my son? I don't even know where he is." 3:30, 4 o'clock, I don't hear any single text. I don't read any single text from him. And I was so worried. "God, where is my son?" 5 o'clock. And then I said, "Lord God," and that's the time I said, "Lord, I entrust his life to you. Take good care of my son, Christian. Take good care of him." And then here comes the text, "Mama, I'm fine. I fell asleep to a friend's house. I got food poisoning. Apple cider and pizza I ate with an empty stomach, it triggered him. The family let him stay, and because he fell asleep, he could not call, he could not text. And the family did not even bother to find out. Probably they thought I knew about it." When I was thinking this and I realized, what about God? He has given his only begotten son, Jesus. Begotten son, Jesus, for each one of us. What was his cry? "I am a mother crying, where is my son? He's not even my own. I was just a steward for him. But I felt so bad." But because of the great love of God, he has given his son, Jesus. And even in his ultimate example of being unselfish, a selflessness act, he did for each one of us. My brothers and sisters, we all know losing someone special in our lives is too difficult. But we are privileged. We are so blessed that we carry on the love of God in our hearts, that whatsoever it may be, persecutions, trials, and worries, sickness and diseases, it's already done deal. Absolutely done deal. The Lord Jesus Christ shed his blood on that cross to wash all our sins. The benefits was given to us. We just apply the wisdom and the knowledge in going back to the scripture, what is best for us. Can I have a song, please? When I was in accident, there was 6 years ago or 5 years ago, this arm cannot even move. I keep telling to the Lord, "Lord God, why me? Why I'm experiencing all these things? Away from my family, go work in other country, just sending money to find out that my father, my mother, my brother, sickness, and now they're all gone. Having a baby, experiencing to even carry a big cyst in my belly, to be even put in the laundry with my husband to sleep because of selfishness of my boss. Because he doesn't want us to come back here in Toronto. wherein my family is here, wherein the fellowship of brethren is here, my church is here. But one thing that I've seen in that place of Greece, God is also there with us. My brothers and sisters, how many difficult times we have in life? How many times that we have even looked upon a stranger, even stretching forth our hands? Do we even close our ears, or we just pretend that nothing happened? Or do we just close our eyes that you don't see anything? The Lord is good. And I say to my Lord God, in this life that is remaining in me, I will offer it to the Lord, no matter what it may be. Yes, I fall. Yes, I fail. Yes, and I just go back to the Lord. He is the only hope that we have. Kung sa buhay po niyo ngayong oras na to, meron kang alalahanin, you are carrying something like heavier that you think. You're carrying the world in your shoulder. There is hope in God. There is hope in God. He has already have suffered, and it's already declared at the cross, it is finished. It is finished. Out of love, great love, emptying himself, even carrying all the burdens, the sin of humanity, he finished them all by dying for that on the cross. If for this very first time that you have come to this place, you probably is questioning in your mind, what is it she's talking about? Why I'm still suffering like this? Why I still have a problem with my relationship? Why I'm still having no job? Why still people hate me? Why? All the questions I've also asked the Lord, saying, but God is giving me always hope, for just He loves me so much. I'd like to pray first for all the first timers that have come in this place. Can you please raise up your hands and just follow with me in this simple prayer? It is so important that that person that we're talking about, our Lord that we have been exalting upon this place, exalting in our lives in this place, is the same God that can even move to your life. Follow me in this simple prayer. Oh God, I know that you love me so much. I know that you have given me your son Jesus to die on that cross because of my sin. And I acknowledge that. That I'm a sinner, and I ask your forgiveness. And I thank you for your promise that whenever I come to you, you will hear me. Whenever I come to you in repentance, you will forgive me. And as I open my heart to you, Lord, come in. Be my Lord and my Savior. Lead me to the way you want me to be. Help me to fully understand your deep things upon my life. I thank you, Lord, for that gift of salvation. In Jesus' name, this I pray. Continue with the song. Even the moment, just give me five more minutes, I know, 5 more minutes. For all the people that are standing there right now, just the extreme need, I just want the extreme need at the moment, for those praying for miracles to happen, come, we will open the altar, just the extreme need. I know you can pray wherever you are, but for those that are really in need of a miracle to happen, your status is about to finish here in Canada. Miracle is about to you know, your hope of healing is about to give up. But God will never give up on you. Just please come across the altar. Not
Nothing is impossible with the Lord to those who believe. Nothing is impossible to those who hope upon the Lord. For a relationship, extreme need, please come. When Jesus raised up a dead person, He can also release. Miracle upon you, for He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Come. May I call the pastors, please, and the tribe leaders. Church coordinator, please help. Let's pray for them. And now for this, a relationship that you think you cannot do anything else, but because you know that in the center of the relationship, when you open the relationship to have Jesus in the center of it, He can move. He can move mightily. There's power in the Lord. Come. Oh Lord God. At that night, when I was thinking about losing my son, what happened to him? For I know worry is an offense to God. I keep hearing that. But at the moment, I felt the worriness, the trouble in my life. But when I put and surrender everything to my God, and here comes the answer. So quick, right away, my son texted me, "Mama, I'm okay." What is the difficult things you have in your life? What may be struggles, persecutions, trials, worries in your life? First coordinator, please help us minister. Tribe leader, Pastor, Brother Harold, please. Brother Edwin, please help us. And you know, my Lord God is never, never lack of anything. You will never, never lack of anything. Oh God, Lord, in your extreme power, in your extreme move, even to those watching television right now, as you stretch forth your hands, there's nothing can hinder God to even release blessing of healing. My father got saved by watching television. He stretched forth his hands as he agreed with the prayer. He stretched forth his hands, he surrendered his body, he received healing. But God is always faithful to His promise. Oh, Lord Jesus. Kung sa pagsubok, may malaking pagsubok sa buhay mo. Mga sakit karamdaman, alam mong wala nang magagawa. The doctor even say, there's nothing. No, hopeless, useless, there's nothing. But there is hope in the Lord. There's hope in God. He is our ultimate source of hope. For you all there, you can just stretch forth your hands, put upon and lay hands, right hands to the body that is sick. Put your hands upon your head, even to the part of the body that is sick, and pray for the healing. In Isaiah 53 verse 5, by His wounds we are healed. We may not be able to memorize all the passages in the Bible, but we hold on to every promises that God has given us. He is the mighty healer. He is our help. He is our refuge. Oh, yes, God. Bless all, Lord Jesus. Help them. And now this time, now to all the workers. I know the workers need prayer at the moment, because sometimes you've given your life from morning to lunchtime to afternoon to be of the service to the Lord, serving God and serving people. We pray for all the divine strength, the restoration of His strength. We pray for the good health. We pray for the manifestation of the power of God to release what is promised unto us. James chapter 1 verse 4. Count it all joy, have the enduring faith, never lack of anything, knowing the wisdom, the divine purpose of God. Why are we experiencing various trials? The divine purpose of God is for us to know more of Him, to go back more of Him. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And even, oh Lord, I'm praying for all the families and all the children. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God.
Rescue the world, this is our God.
For what you have done today. We know, God, that you have given us endurance and encouragement for us to have the same attitude of what you have. You want us to imitate Christ? Help us, oh God. But thank you, Lord Jesus, that in his extreme offering of his life, selflessly, we are now benefiting from what he has done on that cross. Thank you, Lord God, and as I release blessing to all the people, can you please raise up your hands? Please raise up your hands. I always believe, though, that as we raise up our hands, we surrender everything to the Lord. Look up upon heaven and say, Lord Jesus, I thank you. I know, Lord God, that you will continue to release blessing upon the people that are here, especially, oh Lord God, for every cry of the heart, Lord Jesus. You are not abandoning them because you have a great divine purpose that you are allowing, O Lord Jesus, for us to experience trials and difficulties in life. But because of that, Lord Jesus, the encouragement that you've given us in the life of our Lord, Father, we thank you. He is an ultimate example of selflessness in the point of emptying himself of everything, putting down himself in humility to the lowest position. And now you have elevated him, O Lord God, for your glory. Father, bless everyone, every prayer that we have, O Lord God. We know that you are an answering God. In our obedience in doing your will, Lord God, you are a faithful God. Father, thank you. Bless even the household that are here, O Lord, presenting, and even the loved ones. For we believe, O God, your hands is not short to even reach out unto them, and your ears are not dull to even hear our prayers. Father, we entrust everything unto you. Bless you, O God. And even we give you back the highest glory, honor, and adoration. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Sige po. Let us declare that our